Good afternoon, my dear students. Today we are going to start next form of public sector enterprises, that is statutory corporations or public corporations. Students, statutory corporations are such corporations which are formed by passing a special act in the parliament. A special act is passed in the parliament for the formation of statutory corporation. And this act defines the powers, objectives, as well as rules, regulations followed by these statutory corporations. This act also defines what is the relation of public corporation with different department of government. This is the meaning of statutory corporations. There are different examples of statutory corporation like Air India, Indian Airlines, LIC, Reserve Bank of India, Industrial Development Bank of India, Food Corporation of India. All these are examples of public corporation. Now students, I will discuss with you all in which situations public corporation are suitable. So let's start with the first situation. When the enterprise requires huge amount of capital investment. In any enterprise, when large amount of capital is required, then public corporations are suitable there. The enterprise has to be run on business line. When an enterprise is going to be established for doing business activity, for such enterprises, public corporation or statutory corporation are suitable. The public interest must be kept in view by enterprise. When the main objective is social motive, public interest is kept in mind. Their main motive is not to earn profit, main motive is to serve the society. Then public corporation is suitable. So students, in these three situations, establishing statutory or public corporation is better. Now I will discuss with you all what are the features of statutory corporation. First is, statutory corporations are established under an act of parliament. I told you, statutory corporations are formed by passing a special act in the parliament. This act defines the objectives, powers, rules, regulations, as well as the relationship of statutory corporation with different departments of government. Next is, a public corporation is wholly owned by the state. State means government. Public corporation or statutory corporation are completely owned by government. All the finance is invested by government, and whatever profit is earned or losses are suffered, all goes to the government. So third feature is, it has its own separate legal entity different from its members. It means statutory corporations are having separate legal entity. They are considered different from their members. It means statutory corporations can own property, can enter into contracts, and can file cases against others on its own name. Next is, statutory corporation has its own rules regarding recruitment and appointment of employees. They have made their own rules regarding recruitment and appointment of employees, as well as their remuneration. Remuneration means salaries. Next is, public corporation or statutory corporations are managed and controlled by the board of directors, and board of directors are nominated by government. In this way, board of directors manage and control the statutory corporations, and government is having no interference in the day-to-day working of statutory corporations. Next is, statutory corporation has an independent financial structure. These corporations are having their own financial structure. It prepares its own budget. Corporations prepare their own budget, and they are having authority to retain earnings. If required, they can utilize their profits for the benefit of the business corporation. Although
on the earnings of the statutory corporation, government is having a right. But if there is a need, these corporations can utilize their money for the benefit of their corporations. Next is, public accountability is also a prominent feature. Yes, public corporations are also just like departmental undertaking, they are also accountable to the general public through parliament. Next is, public corporation or statutory corporations are formed with a service motive. It means their main motive is to provide services to society and not to earn profits. If profits, if any, are used by it for public welfare. If these corporations are having any of the amount of profit, that profit is used for the benefit of public. So, students, these are the features of statutory corporations which I discussed with you all. I hope the topic statutory corporation, as it is the second form of public sector enterprises, its suitability and features are clear to all. Even then, if you have any doubt, you can discuss with me right now. Okay, students, thank you.